This is a 3D printed microphone. Yeah, metal. One piece. Using a process called binder jetting. Binder jetting? What the hell is that? Stick around. Let's find out.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber.
Make sure that you have notifications turned on for my channel so you don't miss a single episode. And now, a word from our sponsor.
PCBWay offers quick turnaround time for rapid PCB prototyping and small volume production for your next project. Turn time can be as short as 24 hours after approval by their engineers. Multi-layer boards up to 4 layers and as little as 48 hours are also possible. Click the link in the description to get your next project started. The inspiration from this project for this microphone was from the Unidyne 55 microphone. It's incredibly iconic. You see it in the lots of old photos from the 50s and the 60s, and lots of recording musicians have used it over the years, and it was my inspiration to start this project. I wanted to do a new kind of microphone based off of that old kind of vintage industrial sort of style. This was the very first sketch that I did, and this all came about because I was trying to create a microphone that I could use for my YouTube recordings. I didn't really know much about microphones, and I didn't have a very good microphone when I first started, and I thought maybe I could do a DIY sort of ribbon microphone and build my own microphone. And these are some of the first sketches that I came up with. You can see in this sketch, at the top and the bottom, there are little holes, and that's where I thought maybe there would be a mechanical fastener that bolted the three parts of the microphone together. So there might be a right side, a left side, and then a centerpiece, and that would sandwich all the internal components together. I then went to 3D and built some quick sort of visual mock-ups to sort of visualize what I had sketched to see if I liked that before I moved forward. I was pretty happy with the form of the body that I had created, and I reached out to DIYRibbonMic.com, and to my surprise, I got a reply. From there, I ordered up a ribbon motor, and this is what I got in the mail. And so now I knew what size the internal components were, at least the ribbon motor was, so I could continue on designing the body. And here at this point, I still thought that I was going to be making the body out of three pieces, and I hadn't quite discovered the 3D printing process of binder jetting, but it was going to happen soon. I started to build the model in the computer. For real, you can see me placing all the little hexagons here at this point, because I knew that I wanted to have throughput through the entire unit so that the ribbon motor could breathe freely, and I knew that the 3D printing option was going to be a possibility at this point. So with 3D printing as the way to move forward, I of course 3D printed my own PLA prototype so that I could see how big the unit was, how the parts fit inside, as I continue to work on what would be the metal printing option. There are a couple of metal printing options in the world. One is laser, done with a laser, where the laser comes down and it melts the metal together. That is not an option for this kind of a part because it's basically a hollow internal part, and removing the structures the supports from the inside of the body was not going to be an option for 3D metal printing this part. So there came a point where I discovered binder jetting. And binder jetting, one of the advantages of that is that it does not require an internal structure. Its structure comes from the powder when it is being created. And here you can see the internals of the ribbon microphone. There's a transformer and then the XLR cable connection at the bottom. And those are all modeled, of course, in the computer as well to make it so that everything can come together and be captured by that cone at the very bottom and hold it all in place. DMLS is what the other laser metal sintering process is called. So it's called direct metal laser sintering, and that requires supports. And that was not going to be an option. And so ultimately, I discovered the binder jetting process, and I started to talk to people that had binder jetting machines and found out what it was going to take design-wise for this part to be made. And there are actually very few restrictions, so I could pretty much design the part any way that I wanted, and that is perfect, of course, when you're designing something, and if you're not restricted by the manufacturing constraints of how the part is actually made. With binder jetting, the big limitation is just the wall thickness. And as long as the little walls around my hexagons were thick enough, they were going to be able to print whatever I needed. And here's a picture of the first prototype that I got. Let's take a look at what binder jetting is and how it works. You're going to have a build box, and we're going to fill that with powder metal, in this case, steel. The steel is going to be bound together using inkjet technology and a binder that is squirted out of the print heads, just like from your inkjet printer. And just like other 3D printing technologies, it's going to print it layer by layer to build you your part. The part is then cured in an oven, and it becomes tremendously porous as the binder is removed. We're going to put it in a crucible, and we're going to add a wick to the part so that we can wick up some bronze powder. We're going to cover the rest of the part. We're going to put this crucible inside of an oven, and it's going to melt that bronze, and it's going to get wicked up through that wick and then into the part and infuse the part with bronze. So you're going to end up with a steel and bronze part in the end that is very strong, very durable. The process is very much in use today, creating parts across all industries, aerospace, defense, automotive. And the beauty, of course, is there's very little cleanup. You have to, of course, cut off that wick and then clean up the part, but then secondary machining operations can be performed to the part. I've since become very good friends with Rick, who runs the DIYRibbonMicrophone.com. We collaborated closely together on this project to create this prototype. There's actually two of them. I have one and he has the other one. You can see how the pieces go together. You see the XLR connector here at the bottom, all encapsulated by this cone. And the microphone debuted at NAMM in 2017. So I started this project probably late 2016 or mid-2016. Flew out to LA for the NAMM show in 2017 and got to hang out and go to NAMM and talk to people about the ribbon microphone and the technology. Here's some shots from the show, how we had it displayed. It was very well received. And this unit here is actually has a black coating on the top of it to give it a little bit more dark, kind of sinister sort of look. I have the raw metal one in my possession, and that's what I'm actually using to record this video on right now. So all the voiceover in this video was done with this ribbon microphone. So before you go and post in the comments about whether you can have one and get one, the answer is yes. You're going to be about $1,000 for this boutique microphone. They will probably be printed one at a time as the orders come in. I will put an individual serial number into each printing so that you will know which one you have, and we've made two so far. We'll have a ribbon motor built up by Rick directly, and we'll assemble this and ship it off to you. I estimate turnaround time about 2 months to get you one, but basically you will have something that nobody else in the world has. A very exclusive custom ribbon microphone that looks like nothing else out there. If you want to build your own DIY Austin ribbon mic, head on over to DIYRibbonMic.com and you can purchase a kit from them directly. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Hey, and don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook sometimes, Twitter usually, and now Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.